So hello and welcome. I'm gonna make a little video about what you can do with VLC Player. I use it for presentation purposes. You can use it to play movies on the second screen or images like a PowerPoint. But it's more stable. It plays more kinds of files, and you can also load files during the presentation. So it's a very useful tool that a lot of people don't use. The only side note I'm gonna make is that in Windows it's not so useful as in Mac. This is because of the graphics card in Windows is not always putting the output window. Or to explain better, I use a playlist window, which is usually on the laptop screen, and the second screen is the output window, which has the video or the image that you want to show. The problem with Windows is that it will not always show consistently the output window on the right screen. So it happens a lot of times that it will go to the other screen, which is very annoying, because if you do a presentation and you need to show something, and then suddenly the screen flips to the other screen, that's impossible. So I don't use it with Windows, I only use it with Mac. So this is actually Mac only. If you have a solution for the Windows problem, please let me know, because I also use Windows and I would really like to know. But all the solutions I tried did fail. But for no delay now, this is Creative with Tech about VLC Player. Welcome. So the first thing we're going to do, I opened a window, and the first thing we're going to do is go to options, of course. This is the playlist window you see here. I already put some files in there to demonstrate later. I go to options first. Options is located here, command, comma, but it will also be in the options menu. We go to the basic options first. There's one basic option that's very important, it's continue playback. Please put this on never, because it will ask you if you want to play a video. If you played it already, it will ask you, do you want to continue this playback on this video? It will ask you with a menu the second time. So if you test the presentation with some videos and then the second time around you will do the presentation for real, it will just pop up a window which says, do you want to continue playback this video from last point, or do you want to... You never want that. Never, 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 never. That happened to me once. Don't forget this setting to put it on never, because it shows really, really stupid. So that's the first thing. Then we go to show all, which is actually the advanced options. Again, these options. I will just go step by step the options that I think are most important for presentation purposes. So the first thing is input codecs. There's one option here. It is about the demuxers. Demuxers is about image. In the image, you can say the duration in seconds. It's the duration the image will be in your playlist. So if you play an image instead of video, it will also have a playback duration standard. Usually it's 10 seconds. I like to have it 4. That's also the possibility. I will explain that later. But you can play the playlist and then pause, which is an option during every image. Like you put a video, then an image, then a video, then an image, and during the image like a speaker is saying something, and then you will pause the image. So maybe you want some more seconds or some less seconds then, because you have to pause it somewhere. It's not possible to auto pause the images and autoplay the videos like in PowerPoint. You have to choose. It's also possible to auto pause every, that's what I do actually, I auto pause every image and video in the end, so that then this setting is not that important anymore. But for people who want to know, it's here. It's very hard to find. It's demuxer image. Okay, then we go to video. Video has some very important settings, of course, because it's video. Enable video is very important, of course. Next thing, full screen video output. You can do this, you can't, depends on what you want. I really like to don't put it on output, because then when I test it, it will go full screen immediately, and then I will lose my mouse and everything and whatever. I like to put it on a separate window, then I can drag the window to the right output window, and then full size it with double clicking on the window. So I like to uncheck this actually. This is very important. The next one is embedded video. Embedded video will, if you uncheck it, it will separate your playlist from your video output. So you can put your playlist on the one screen and then your video output on the other screen. This is exactly what you want for presentations. This is a very important option. Then we go to a disable screensaver, of course, always. And show media title on video. You want to also uncheck this one because you don't want the media title to show on your video during a presentation. It can have a very weird title. It will be very ugly. Don't show the media title, just don't do it. After that we go to subtitles, OSD. Let's see, on-screen display, you want to uncheck this one. You don't want the play, pause buttons, everything to display on your video during presentations, because you have the playlist window to control your second screen, so you don't need the buttons actually. So please uncheck it, because it will be very ugly as well. Then we have the logo overlay, which can be useful if you have a company logo or something. Use the logo overlay to put in a logo. You can put it wherever you want, opacity, whatever. You can put the logo over your whole presentation or your own logo, whatever you want. After that we go to, let's see what's also important, is audio, of course. Enable audio is of course important. Remember, the audio volume can be very useful if you set the audio volume to a certain volume, and then during the presentation you of course want to have the same volume, of course. You don't want to have that you put it very quietly or very loud, and then next thing it will be set to basic again. Just remember, never put your audio volume, that was also here, I'll show you here, never go beyond this stripe. This is 100%. Don't go to 125 or 200. The old players can also go to 200. It will distort your audio, so never go over the 100%. So the stripe here, the little stripe, 100%, never go over it. Don't do it. It will be very ugly during presentations. So that's about audio. Also peak protection, of course, is very important, that you don't want any peaking audio. After that we go to the last thing on our list, is playlists. Playlist is very important, of course, because we have the playlist in our second or in our first window. So this is the settings I use. One of the most important ones is of course repeat all, because in the end you want to repeat to the beginning, especially if you just go through the presentation one time and then you want to repeat it the next time. And also very important to put this, because usually what I do is you use the company slide or whatever as the first slide with the logo. Sometimes you forget to put one in the end, so you have the last video, you go to the next slide and it will suddenly close down VLC. You don't want that. That's then you will see your desktop. If you don't change your desktop to a certain picture, it will maybe see a naked lady, whatever. So that's not a good idea. So then you put it on repeat all. So the first, after the last video, the first picture will be shown again. So if you accidentally go to the last video and after that you go to the next one, you will go to the first picture. That can be a mistake as well, but it will always be less of a mistake than closing down VLC, and that will be very unprofessional. So repeat all. Last thing, play and pause. I already talked about this. I always put it on play, and then it will pause in the end. From the next, I will show that. Here, I have some files in here. You'll see, I will go to the first file. This will play on the second window that you don't see now. I will have one picture. It will play for 4 seconds, then it will pause. So the picture will stay in the window. It go manually, I can go double click on the next one. It will play the next one and then pause. I can also do this with command arrow to the left or arrow to the right. It will go from one to the other, which is very useful. You can also pause with the space bar, of course, which is if you don't automatically pause, it will be useful. And you can also go with arrows down and then enter the thing you want to start. So you can go through your playlist like this. If you need, if you have an extra file somewhere, like I got one here that's to edit during the show, you can just edit where you want. The show will continue and you can just put it in somewhere. So if somebody is late and you need some video to be played, you can just put in the USB stick and just put it in your show somewhere. So this is very useful to put the playlist on the first screen. So that's that for now. I hope you find this information useful. Please like the video and share it with your colleagues or other people. And then we make a better world together, or something like that. Some bullshit. Sorry, I was just distracted. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time with the next video. Bye bye.